Programming style. The main point of style guidelines are: your code should be easily readable, should be consistent, and you should know accept the best practices, meaning, playing along with everyone else in the world is writing the same language, because it's going to make it easier to read example code, recognizing where the code you're looking at is written well. Let's take a look at a few examples of style guidelines for JavaScript and similarly many other languages, particularly C-based ones. JavaScript, naming conventions. We already seen that the rules of JavaScript say, you must use letters, numbers, dollar sign, underscore, and you can't start with a number. But doesn't mean something like this would be a good idea for a variable or function's name. This will be allowed, but is preferred clarity, we want clear ability, we want meaning. Now when we are learning, we often use placeholder names, for example a variable called A, one called B, or C. We can pick any letters that we like, or we can use common meaningless words like varfu or varbar. But keep in mind that our real variable names must represent meaningful information, a name, a date, the height and width of an image, and so on. Naming conventions develop over the years, and these days the dominant JavaScript is written is this: variables and functions are written in Camelcase format. This means, is the variable name, starts in lowercase. But if you have more than one word, we capitalize the first letter of the subsequent word, like the hump of a camel. Some other languages separate multiple words with an underscore. Now functions are named the same way. With functions we typically use multiple words, for clarity, for example, calculate distance, or check form field, often in a loose verb known format. Also the internal functions inside JavaScript use this format too. Create element, append child, get element by ID. Now in other languages, their style guidelines might suggest to use underscores to separate words instead, or if it's strongly typed, they might suggest you to prefix your variables with an abbreviation to represent the type of information in that variable, like if it is a string or an integer. Now another style issue is something called brace style, literally, where you put the opening and closing curly braces, and how much to indent your code. The dominant style in JavaScript is the most traditional brace style for C-based languages. If you have an if statement or while loop, the curly brace will opening on the same line as the keyword. Then your code is indented inside the block, and the closing curly brace closes on a line by itself, matching up with the keyword. Now if you're using an if and else, you typically see else written in one line, with both the closing of the previous block and the opening of the next. And there are other ways, like Pascal or Holman style, where the opening brace is put it on his own line and aligns up with the closing brace. This is very common on languages like C#. But with JavaScript, with his whiles, fors, and his functions, for all of this constructions, opening the curly brace on the same line of the keyword. And as we already seen, functions should be defined before their calls. If you have code that you know is calling a function later on in that file, rearrange them to make them easier to read and easier to understand. So let's review this guidelines. Some simple rules to keep in mind. We use Camelcase for variables, functions and methods. We open the curly braces on the same line. We define our functions before we call them. Always use semicolons to end a statement. Always use var when declaring a variable. Now, these guidelines are enough to get started, but if you want to go deeper, you can make a search for JavaScript style guidelines, and you will find the good documents that have been created by the JavaScript developers in places like Google or Yahoo, or search for available start guidelines for any other language you might be interested in.